Hi everybody, my name is Hannah and this is Pepper and Pine, and today I have a super easy tutorial to share with you. We are making bar lotion with just 3 ingredients, and you can add any essential oil you'd like to this. Alright, so this is a really easy recipe. It's just a 1:1:1 ratio of beeswax, shea butter, and coconut oil. You can find more information about these 3 products down in the description box below. So I'm putting it all into a glass jar. Next, we're going to put that jar into a pot of boiling water. I went ahead and transferred it to a smaller pot so that the water level could be higher. Now, it doesn't take long before these ingredients start to melt. Now, if you use the beeswax in the pellet form, it will melt faster. But overall, it didn't take more than 15 minutes for this mixture to melt completely. I stirred it around just a little bit here and there, and you can see that only the beeswax is left to melt completely, but at about 15 minutes, everything is melted. Now, the solution is still really hot, so I would give it just a couple of minutes to begin to cool down before you add your essential oils, just to make sure that your essential oils don't evaporate in the process. I'm using some vanilla essential oil, and while this did smell pretty good, it's certainly not my favorite. I think peppermint or lavender smell a lot better when it comes to bar lotions, and later on I'm going to show you an alternative. Now I have all these tiny little jars, and I'm going to go ahead and fill them up with that hot solution. You can see that they start to cool down and solidify pretty quickly, and in less than an hour they will be solid. The last thing I want to do is add a little lid, and this project is done. So here's an alternative for this bar lotion, and that's to add some rosemary to your solution while it's still warming up. Get those flavors to infuse. And for this project, I'm going to use my silicone molds by melting pots, and your bar lotion will pop right out. I'm also using some lavender essential oil to flavor this bar lotion, and I really like this combination. However, I didn't strain out all of those leaves, and that posed to be a problem, so I would recommend that you strain them out before you pour them in. Because they are so soft, those leaves are going to start to break apart as you use your lotion bar. All right, so several hours later, you can see how easily these pop out of that mold, and they smell amazing. Now, the shea butter does have a really strong scent, and it tends to overpower all the other essential oils that I'm adding to these bar lotions. So you may want to cut down your shea butter or find one that isn't so strong in smell. I hope you try this super simple project. I absolutely love this bar lotion. It is the only one that I use now. It leaves your skin so soft and smelling great. And the best part is that it's made with all natural, simple ingredients. If you want to see some of the other projects and tutorials on my channel, you can tap on the screen right now. And don't forget that you can see what we're up to on a daily basis by finding me on Instagram at Pepper and Pine.